I see on a lot of car pages people asking, hey, I just got this car, I don't know what to do. What should be some things that I can do to my car to make it look different? How should I start modding it? And if that's you, then this is the right video for you, because I'm gonna go in on five ways or five different things that you can do to your car to make it look different from the get-go. Alright, with that being said, let's get into the video. Welcome back, guys. If you're new here, my name is Arthur and I mod the 2008 Scion TC. So in today's video, I'm gonna talk to you guys about the first five things you can do to make your car look different from stock from the get-go, alright? So if you guys are watching this video, first I recommend on why, you know, start with the cheap car, and you can watch this video with the card right up here before watching this video, so it'll make a little bit more sense, okay? So this is the second video of the series that I just started. And again, thank you so much for being part of it. The one thing that will change the look of your car the most from stock to not looking as stock as it would be a window tint. So changing the tint on your guys' vehicles from stock tint or no tint at all to a little bit darker, you know, I recommend staying within the guidelines. But obviously, as those car guys, we usually get illegal tint depending on your state and what the percentage is. But not only does it change the whole entire vibe of the car, it gives it like that meaner look, that more privacy look, and it can just look stylish as people get different colors of tint, you know, such as reflective tint or purple tint or whatever it may be, you know. So that's one thing you can do to your car that will make it look different from the get-go. The second thing, guys, the second thing you can do to make your ride look different is obviously wheels. So choosing the right set of wheels for your car is very, very important. You gotta know, you know, how wide do you need them, you know. Do you need 17s, 18s, things like that. But the putting new wheels on your car does definitely change the look of your car. It makes it look more aggressive, more sporty, more stylish for whatever look you're trying to go for. You know, obviously there's different type of wheels for different things, and different people have different tastes. You know, some people get black wheels, some people get colored wheels, you know, trying to color scheme their car and things like that. So that's the second thing that can make your car look furthest from stock, but also the best second thing to do to your car if you're looking to mod it or simply just make it a more stylish look. Because I like to be different, and I like to my car to look good when I'm driving it for me, not for others. But I just like my car to look good, and that's the style that I'm going for. And if you guys want to see my build, you can go to my channel and just look at the other videos that I've been posting, and you guys can check them out. All right that being said, guys, it takes us to our third thing that will make your car look the best, or not the best, but just different from stock. So the third thing you can do to your car, and that would be changing the height of your car. So whether you have a truck and you want to put a lift, or you want to lower it, or whether you just have a regular sedan, you know, making it lowered with those nice new wheels and that tint you have will change the look of your car dramatically. So that's the third thing you can do to your car that will make it look insanely whatever you wish for. You know, if you're going off-roading, you might want to raise it a little bit, you know, so you don't get stuck on those rocks, on the sand. Obviously, you would do that with the Jeep or truck or whatever it is that you're taking off-roading. If you just want to look stylish and you got good roads, you know, dropping it a little bit, whether that's springs you're choosing, you know, maybe a little bit bouncy, same from experience. But if you choose the right, you know, springs, do your little research, it can be a nice way to start in dropping the height of your car. As if you go with coilovers, you know, you might see a little bit more difficulty. And if you go way too low, you might see some problems happening to your car. As you can see in some of my videos, I did have that problem, but I learned from it. So hey, if you're gonna lower your car, make sure you do it correctly and that you know what you're looking for. You know, the fourth thing for me when I was doing my car was a cold air intake or an exhaust. Now, I went with both because I could, but the first thing I installed was the cold air intake. It gave that nice little sound and a little bit louder than your original sound. And it just made it sound good, you know, you could hear the air coming in and everything like that. So cold air intake or an exhaust, and make sure you go with the decent brand exhaust if you don't want that raspy sound, okay? All right, so that leads us to the final thing that can make your car look the most different from stock that you can appreciate. And that would be something interior wise. So if you're looking for, you know, new seats, or if you're looking for a new steering wheel, I would say those are two great choices that you can make. However, steering wheel will be much cheaper than getting seats. So I run a Grip Royal custom made steering wheel deep dish with the NRG hub and quick release. And that changes the interior look, you know, it makes it look a lot more appreciative and it just looks cool. And then when you go to car shows or car meets, you can just take off your steering wheel and be like, hey guys, check this out. Obviously for safety reasons, if you're not comfortable by not having an airbag, or your parents, you know, are very, very concerned for those things, then I would consider saving up some more money and getting some seats. But then again, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for all my new subscribers. Thank you for all the love the channel's been getting this past few days. I can't believe where we are at right now. We're almost at 300 subscribers, guys. We're, I think, 30 subscribers away from hitting 300. And that's amazing in a short little amount of time. It's unbelievable. But then again, guys, those are the five things you can do to your car to change the look dramatically. So if you're looking on how to start modding your car, I hope I helped answer some questions. I hope I helped guide you and the things you need to look for and what they do for your car. And with that being said, guys, make sure you comment down below. What are you gonna do to your first mod to your car, or what was it that you did first to your car? And with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.